Doctor, it's not just that we are in the midst of a transition in the executive branch, actually a transition across all of government, really, as we switch. And so that's going to be difficult to look for federal responses. So the governors need to step up. But every state's different, too. This should have always been part of the solution.
Yeah, well, I think what you're going to see is the governors starting to work together, at least on a regional basis. And they've been having discussions about trying to come up with regional solutions because, you know, the virus doesn't respect state sovereignty. It crosses borders. And so what you're having is regional kinds of epidemics. You're having state-based policies that are producing regional effects. And so if the states work together within the regions where we're seeing the spread be more contiguous, that's going to be far more effective. We saw Michigan go first last night with some targeted mitigation. I think you're likely to see more states take those kinds of steps. So we're not going to have the broad-based shutdowns that we had before. Manufacturing won't be stopped. Construction won't be stopped. Retail won't be stopped. But what they're going to target are indoor congregate settings where people gather in groups and they can't mask. So restaurants, bars, clubs, gym classes, things like that. And that's exactly what Michigan focused on. Also high schools. I think what you're likely to see is districts that are currently open, they're losing teachers. Teachers are in quarantine. They're getting sick. So what they're likely to do is try to preserve the elementary schools, which I think is prudent because in-class learning for younger children is more important. We also know the younger kids are at less risk than the older kids. And they're likely to close the high school and middle schools to try to reapportion teachers back to the elementary schools. That's, in fact, what my district has just done.
So we want to do everything that we can, and you've always pointed that out in terms of sequestering, quick tests, masks, and everything. But we still need to go to the most vulnerable people and try to use a special amount of attention to those that are vulnerable to sequester those people. I mean, there will still be spread. It's happening. We can see it.
Right. I mean, the problem is we're not doing a very good job of protecting the vulnerable. We've been talking about that for a long time. There's 20,000 infections a week ago in nursing homes, 2,000 deaths, and it's going up. So, you know, the challenge is when you have a lot of spread at a community level, you really can't fully prevent it from getting into those congregate settings where vulnerable populations live. And so the key is to try to reduce the level of community spread to the extent you can. And so you're likely to see these targeted types of steps. These are the same things that the South did. Arizona, Texas did as well when they had epidemics in the South. More targeted measures trying to look at congregate settings that are more purely recreational, things like bars. In Michigan, for example, they didn't shut down the restaurants. They just closed them to indoor dining. They're allowing outdoor dining with heat lamps and they're allowing takeout food. You know, right now we're diagnosing probably about 1 in 4 infections. The RT, the rate of transfer, is probably about 1.15 or 1.20. If you assume an infection fatality rate that's been cut in half and is about 0.45%, that means at the current run rate, just at the current run rate, not getting any worse, but not getting any better, we're going to have 200,000 additional deaths between now and the end of January. So that's what we're looking at. That's what people are trying to prevent right now.
Hey, Dr. Gottlieb, I know that we keep talking about testing and contact tracing, but I have to say my own experiences just in the last couple of weeks with trying to find testing for my son and then having a friend who came down with this, I'm incredibly disappointed by how difficult it is to try and get testing. I'm incredibly disappointed by the lack of contact tracing. This is New Jersey, where we're supposed to be doing better with this than other states. But I have to tell you, it's really difficult to navigate, even as somebody who's a pretty informed consumer trying to go through these things. And there's been zero contact tracing with some of the people I know who have gotten this.
Yeah, look, I think some states are doing better than others. I think Connecticut's doing a good job. I've talked to my governor about it, Massachusetts, Maryland. There are some states. New York's doing a good job. I don't know a lot about New Jersey, but keep in mind, we're getting to the point where we're exhausting our ability to do the case-based interventions, the tracking, the tracing as a tool to try to control spread. And that's why you're seeing us go to more population-level mitigation. The contact tracing and the case-based interventions work when you have a low level of spread and you can really go after each individual case. So if you're Singapore or Australia, New Zealand, China, it works. But in the United States, where you're having, you know, 600,000-700,000 infections a day, we're exhausting our ability to contact trace each individual infection. We have to go to more population-level approaches. Not back to the lockdowns. We're not going to do that, but I think you're going to see a replica of what we did in the South when the South had their epidemic, where it was more targeted, the mitigation. The testing has become pressed again. The big national labs, Quest and LabCorp, still have availability. The problem isn't that we don't have testing equipment. We have platforms that are capable of running tests. The problem is that we don't distribute test samples very well in this country. So, you know, certain labs get overloaded while other labs have idle capacity because we really don't have a more coordinated system at a state level to get samples to the labs that actually have capacity.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.